Welcome back, friends. In this video, I'll be talking on how to connect to Unix server via WinScp. Okay. So in my previous videos, I have talked on how to create this Unix instance on cloud for practice purpose. And in the last video, I have shown you how we can connect to that particular instance via PuTTY. Okay, which is the SSH client used to interact with a Unix server securely. Okay, so that's the PuTTY. Basically, it's an SSH client. Okay, the another thing what we have is WinScp. Okay, so in this video I'll be talking on what is WinScp and how we can download, install and connect to the Unix server via WinScp. Okay, so what is WinScp? So WinScp is basically a free file transfer tool for Windows that supports FTP, SFTP and SCP. Okay, all these are the transfer types which we will be talking in next few videos. Okay, and the basic beauty of this WinScp is it provides the Windows Explorer type interface that lets you do a drag and drop of files or folders in between your local and remote machines. Okay, unlike your PuTTY, which is just like a command prompt, it's not that user friendly. The WinScp is a bit user friendly and it is Windows style, and to transfer the file from Unix to local machine to Unix, or to perform edit operations or to create files and to perform many operations, we will be using this WinScp, which is Windows style. Okay, so to work with Unix via PuTTY, if you are a bit experienced, you will enjoy working via PuTTY. But if you are a beginner, then you will find this WinScp little useful for you. You will find it more comfortable as compared to PuTTY. Okay, so how to download WinScp? So to download WinScp, this is their official URL, winscp.net. I just clicked on it and it will take me to the download URL. Okay, so here I'm on the URL winscp.net. Okay, here you can see it's a free SFTP, SCP, S3 and FTP client for Windows. Basically, it is for Windows. So I'm going to download WinScp here, and yeah, the download has started and fine. So meanwhile it downloads, we'll be running the WinScp installer as like how our normal program we install. Okay, so the download is completed. I'm just opening installer. Great, accept the terms. You can just go through the terms and click on accept and typical installation I want. I'm going to use it as Explorer. Okay, because we want it Windows style. I clicked on next, I clicked on install, and it is going to install WinScp for me. Okay, now it is asking me, you have stored session sites in PuTTY SSH client. Do you want to import them into WinScp? So my particular WinScp has already detected that you are using PuTTY SSH client and it has some sessions stored. Okay, so if you remember, I stored some sessions to it. Okay, so if I open PuTTY. Okay, so you can see here I have stored some session over here. This is what. Okay, so it is asking me, do you want to use that? I'll click on yes, go ahead and use it. Unix, this is the one which I stored. Go ahead and use it. So that great. I clicked on launch. Now it will open. Okay, so this is the one which I stored. Okay, so I'm just going to click on login. So the username is Prakash. Fine, and save it. I'm going to click on login. Fine, so now you can see I am already logged in. Okay, so this is basically the WinScp Explorer. Okay, and if you see, if you go to the root folder, you can find these mini files. Okay, so let me go to putty and let us compare. Okay, so now currently I am into the directory Prakash. Okay, and where is this Prakash directory? If I give command like pwd, that is my present working directory, it is giving me the location. It is present under home/Prakash. So if I go to home, okay, and if I go to Prakash, it is giving me okay, so it is showing me under Prakash I have these four files, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so now I'll check the same thing over here. So to check the list of file, we'll be using ls, that is list, but here it does not give me any list because all these four files, you can see they are starting with dot, that is they are hidden. Okay, and to see the hidden files, we need to use hyphen a as a parameter, and if I use hyphen a as a parameter, you can see now I am able to see .sss.profile /bash/rc and bash logout. You can see again a single dot and double dot. So the single dot is nothing but my current directory, double dot is nothing but previous directory, that's what it refers to. Okay, now see, this makes very simple. Now let us say by any chance I want to go to this SSH folder. Okay, now you can see the difference. Okay, so SSH is highlighted with different color. Okay, and here you can see SSH as a folder, right? So that means the files and folders are colored in different way. Okay, so the folders are with blue color and your files are with white. Okay, that is again something you can configure later on, but that's the basic thing that with the color itself we can differentiate them. Now let us say I want to go to the SSH folder, so I'll do cd, we'll use cd command to change directory. So I am going to sh command, and again I am doing ls hyphen a to find out all the files I have. So I have some file called as authorized key. Okay, here authorized key. Now let us say I want to edit this file authorized key. Okay, ideally we should not edit these files, keys files and all, but just for an example I want to edit any of the file. Okay, so how I will do it in from putty, I'll be doing it like cat and my file name, and basically here it is the file. Okay, so if you are a beginner and if you see something like that the very first time, you will get very disappointed. Okay, but if you go to this WinScp Explorer and if you go to .ssh, here you see something called as authorized key, and if you open this, you can see you have opened it in a notepad and you are pretty good with this. You can edit it very easily, right? So that's what it gives you, the Windows like structure. Okay, and here you see only Windows file. Okay, and what I said, WinScp is used to transfer the file from your local machine to Unix server, right? Now let us take an example. On your Unix server, you want to create new file, so here you can find one direct option as create new file. Let us give file name as file1. Okay, and I'll give some text as text, and I'm going to save it, and now your file is created in the directory Prakash. Okay, so it is seeing, it is connecting and it is uploaded, 100% completed, and you can see file is present over here, right? You should see the same file from putty as well. Let me so now I should go to my home folder. Okay, so to go to the home directory, we have one command called cd tilde. Okay, I'll be talking again on that later on. Now if I find out a list over here, list of files, now we can see I have file 1 present over here, that is what I just created. Okay, so that's how we can use either of the way. Basically the WinScp is good UI and you can work with that very easily. Okay, and one more thing. Okay, now here on this prompt you can see only the Unix files. Now if you want to see a Windows file and you just want to do a drag and drop of the files, you can change the mode from this setting. You can go to setting, you can go to interface, and you can change the mode to commander. Okay, so if I click on OK and I need to restart my WinScp, let me do that. Now this time, can you see something different? Did it connect? Okay, and this time you see something different. On the left side, you see files from your Windows, from your C drive, users, my name. And on the right hand side, you can see the files from your Unix server. Right, so now let us take an example. You want to upload some files, okay? So let me go to my some directory. Let me go to my G drive, and let us say I want to upload this some file, Oracle DB data. Okay, so I'll be just doing a drag and drop over here, and it is going to copy the file. Now you can see the file is uploaded to my Unix server, right? You can verify the same thing from here, right? Can you see now? It has the file Oracle DB.data, right? On the similar line, if you want to download any file, you can just do a drag and drop. Let us say I want to download this file, file 1, from Unix server to my local. I am just doing drag and drop into my local, and I should see the file as file 1 downloaded to my local. So that's it. Basically, it's a it provides you the very good UI to work with files, just to transfer your files. Okay, along with transfer, it gives you the way to change the properties, to edit the files, to create new files, to create new directories. It gives you the most of the functionality with UI rather than using it on PuTTY. Okay, so going forward, we will be talking about both the things, okay, whenever we need. Okay, so fine, so that's what I wanted to show you in this video, how you can connect to your Unix server via WinScp. Okay, so fine, thank you.